as long as they don't know what you're doing in the background. I would use it if I have a business idea. So these are the APIs that are available on Google Predict. So this is API version 1.5. So these are different things that you could do. You can, so I use this to build my model. This, you see the training model predicts. This is the one I use to build my model. So you can see it. Just for simplicity's sake. So I have already built the model. So what I'll do is that I'll try to use this API to list all the models that exist in my accounts, so that you can see what models it is. So I'm clicking on list. So I'm saying max results 5. Again, it is off, so I need to switch it on. I'm switching it on. So it is on now, you can see it is on. And I'll just say execute. And after execution, it came back with this is what the request, this is the response. It showed what model existed. So this is the response. So it says it came out with the model is of the kind of prediction list. Its name is model ID is language 1. And it says its training status is done. It's ready. Okay? It already says its classification accuracy is 0.98. So it's a very accurate model. That is what they are claiming it is. We'll see how accurate it is. And it says the number of labels, so I'm trying to predict 3 labels. So it is not a binary classifier, right? 3 labels. So I'm trying to predict English, Spanish, and French. These are the 3 languages I'm predicting here. And we'll play a small game here to predict like who, whatever you choose as a, is there anybody like who speaks Spanish? Anyone? None?
No, you know, I'm not Espanol.
Oh, okay, cool. If you can write whatever you just said here, so that you can predict whether the prediction work is working fine or not.
Yeah,
it's
accuracy. Does that mean that you also run the test there?
Yeah, validation. So we've already done validation on it, so it is giving you the accuracy of 0.98 accuracy. So that needs to be very, very good. Yeah, go ahead.
Can you walk us through what it takes to go through the training, what are the steps?
You don't have to do it, just explain.
So the steps are collect the data, okay? Put it in the CSV format. First row is the label that you want to predict, and all the rest of the columns are actual data. So in my case, in this particular case which we are describing right now, the first column was the language, English, Spanish, French, English, Spanish, French, like all those things, and the data was actual sentence.
You can have more than 3 languages.
This is just for sample. Yeah, I could have 10,000 languages inside it, and each of those labels. So ideally speaking, the binary classification works the best, actually. Binary classification, like if you are only trying to predict 2, the more number of classifications you add, the accuracy starts kind of going down. So this is the label. I'll just copy the label, my ID of the predictive model. I'll go back to the prediction API. Now I'll call predict. So now that I've seen that my model is already there, it is ready, and I know what kind of model it is, I can use predict. So I use the predict API, I add the model ID, this is my model ID, and so you see the result is already not there, I'm going to execute and then it will show up, it's not selected on that screen, right? Okay. So request body you have to add, property, input, property, yeah, so who was Spanish here? You were. Come ahead, you have to write it.
I just said that I can speak.
Use Google Translate.
Yeah.
No,
this is fun, right? We will write a sentence here and we'll see whether the prediction works or not.
Hello?
Hola is the common word.
Hello?
Hello?
Let me type it.
Yeah,
we could try it with an English.
You type here the sentence.
Put me in the sentence, right?
No, just write it right.
And you don't have the little accent.
Execute.
predictive French. Was it French?
No.
So see, this is what happens in predictive. So you got it. See, this is what it predicted. So how it predicted was,
it
said English, there is a probability of 0.309, French is probability of 0.37, and Spanish is 0.31. So now this, see, it predicted in French. So that it's not actually probability, they just give a scoring number. And whichever number is the highest, they think that might be the answer. So this is the beauty of predictive model. See, in front of you, you saw a wrong answer. Now let me, I know English, I'll type English, let's see whether it finds it.
I'll try the French one.
Yeah, come, write French. Go ahead. That's what I wanted, I want participation from people, so just try.
How much you learn it, how much you make it.
Well, here's the percentage, does it use a weightage of the first given to English, then to French, and then to Spanish?
No, actually, I'd say it's interesting, actually. Internally, what multi-level classifier does, it builds individual binary classifiers for each of them. So they are mutually exclusive to each other. That's why you see the number, they don't add up to one. People might think that if I have, each of them will get individually labeled, like what the value is, and then you can see whichever gets the highest value, that's the label you produce. You think this is the label that it is. But as you could see in the previous case, we typed Spanish and it predicted French. And now he's typed French, so let's see whether it predicts Spanish or not. Maybe the label has been inaccurate.
He'll think it's English.
So let's say execute. Yeah, they predicted French. Yeah, so maybe
you predict French for
everything. Yeah, maybe. let's try. If anybody else wants to try, let's try English.
Improve your Spanish. I know, I need to improve my Spanish.
Yeah. So.
Google is always right.
Yeah. So I'll write. I know Spanish. I'll just write spam. Yeah, I know Spanish. Let's see. That it does spell check or something like that.
Not a spelling is wrong.
Yeah. Okay. And it tells like how much time it took to run this thing. It predicted English. So it does predict English as well. But we wanted to see whether it predicts Spanish. Come with some other simple thing instead. Let's see whether it predicts or not.
Well, if you write a simple sentence.
Yeah, and convert it into Spanish on Google Translate.
No.
Yeah.
So if you write a simple new sentence.
Yeah.
Write a simple English sentence and its probability, the scoring for that is something like 0.3, and that means it's not a very good idea. For example, in English sentence, should I go to
the
H of
work
and
then
H of Y
after
it?
Spanish outcome. It predicted Spanish.
Again.
No, no, just scroll further down.
The last time, I'll show you.
What's the percentage?
Maybe that's the line he has in this year.
Wow.
So, if you were to use this, like, how would you determine whether whether to use the actual label it predicted, like from a confidence score perspective?
Yeah. Because that's when you use evaluation. So if you see my previous slide that I showed, that you have to contest continuously evaluate. So like the first answer in which it came, it was French, it predicted as Spanish, and this is false positive.
Yeah. But for me, when you were to deploy it, like how would you know a given prediction, the quality of whether, like if they're all 0.3, for example, 0.31, 0.30. Like, how would you know whether to even take the dominant one?
So first, I'll try to answer that. So I don't know how come my slide didn't have that. I mean, I had a ROC curve actually there. I think I added those slides. Where did those slides go? Okay, maybe I might have forgotten about it. But anyway, whenever you build a model, there is an evaluation step. And in the evaluation step, you actually go ahead and find out for the outcomes that you already know answers of. You don't feed this data in the training data. So you separate the training data and the test data. So there are two concepts. So suppose you have a data file which has all the answers as well as the question. So whole file into the training data set, divided into training and test. So training data set is used to build the model, and test data set is to evaluate. So you already know the answer, what is the correct answer here.
Yeah.
And then you see what is the percentage of false positive, false negative, etc. And then you tune your model until you get a desired result.
And was that the 0.98? That was
it said the prediction accuracy is 0.98, correct.
Yeah.
So, but this model has been built like several months back actually. When I first started using it, I used it. So its data is not most relevant or most accurate. And it also depends upon the number of data set size you have. So now what happens is that in any model that you build will always have false positive,
right,
false negative. These will always be there. And true negative and true positive will also be there. All you could do is, you can see for your particular use case, is accuracy more important, precision more important, recall is more important, sensitivity is more important. So it's for different people, different things are important. Yeah, go ahead, you had a question.
So do you have like an Excel or something with your data so we can see what data you
use? I can see, it's not in Excel, it is a CSV file. We can see the data.
Yeah, can we see that?
Yeah, you can see that.
How many?
I think it had around 14,000. So this product actually automatically divided into training and testing.
So when you see the Excel file,
no, this is not Excel file. It's CSV file. Simple track file.
Yeah. What does the result look like?
This is the result.
This is what result look like.
Yeah.
This is the result. For each text, it says whether it's English or Spanish.
No. So evaluation is, this is not evaluation, this is prediction.
This is prediction.
This is prediction. So when you initially build your model, it will build a model. Internally hidden from you, it will do an analysis.
Abstractly, yes.
Yeah, it will do an analysis, then it will find out with the accuracy score, which you saw as 0.98.
I got that, yes.
So it has already done that. It is not showing you the outcome here.
Okay.
But if you want, it can throw a confusion matrix in front of you. How many false positives are there?
Okay,
how many
so the matrix is the basically a final output of my input CSV.
Okay. I mean, it may come out with the output or it may not at all come out. Like some algorithms don't even throw any output. It's just that's it. You have to keep evaluating. So this I'm using, considering I have done the evaluation and everything and I think I'm good, and that's when I use it. So, does it answer?
Yeah.
So, I mean,
can we actually, because we are running
finish
with just show the file and we'll do the raffle and after that you can make go around and ask.
Okay. File, I'll show the file also. But you can ask the question I am hearing.
Oh, no.